Maybe you can go home again. Actor Jeff Daniels did it and even built his own professional theater company. Jeffrey Brown visited Daniels in his Michigan hometown.
He's going to insist that if you want the part, you either audition together or go home.
In the new play casting session, two actors vying for the same role, desperate for any role, await their auditions. The playwright is Hollywood and Broadway actor Jeff Daniels, who's known both the highs and lows of his profession.
I've been in this waiting room where you're just trying to get the next gig, the next job that pays $125 a week, and maybe someone will come and see it and maybe get you a better job, but got to get this one. And
that was you?
That was me for years.
The board believes you're no longer necessary to this company.
At 60, Daniels is seemingly everywhere now, with major roles in two big new movies, Steve Jobs.
He's going to starve to death long before we can help.
And The Martian.
Good evening, I'm Will McAvoy.
He won an Emmy 2 years ago for his starring role as a television news anchor on HBO's The Newsroom.
You have been faking for 20 years?
And last year, he reprised his role in the lowbrow comedy Dumb and Dumber 2.
Awesome!
If you're gonna live in Michigan in the middle of a movie career and try to sustain it, my theory was you better have range.
You went to Central Michigan?
Early in his career, Daniels and his wife Kathleen made a decision about how they would live their lives.
I knew it was a risk, and I had come back for 3 summers.
A risk because you're kind of leaving behind.
Why aren't you moving to L.A.?
Yeah. I mean, you're an actor, right?
You're an actor.
You gotta be in New York or you gotta be in L.A.
Yeah. What do you mean you're going to Michigan? Why? Well, it's home.
Daniels had grown up in the small rural town of Chelsea, Michigan, about an hour west of Detroit. Its major claim to fame as home to Jiffy Mix muffins. A teacher encouraged Daniels to act in high school plays. He left college when he was accepted into an important apprenticeship program at the Circle Rep Theater in New York, renowned for fostering acting talent and showcasing new American plays.
I gotta speak to you.
You mean me?
He had some success in films, including at age 30 in Woody Allen's Purple Rose of Cairo. But Daniels says,
I didn't trust it. I never trusted it. I still don't.
Meaning what? Trust.
Meaning you're absolutely brilliant. You're brilliant. Oh my God, you have changed the way that actors should act. And you start to go.
People said that.
there's the extremes.
Right, of course.
The extremes. Yeah. Not only the highs, but the you're over, your career's over.
Right.
There's no consistency there. This is consistent. Okay.
This is the life Daniels created by returning home to Chelsea, raising 3 children here, and 25 years ago, building his own Purple Rose, the Purple Rose Theater.
Initially, there were a lot of people going, you know, your theater won't work. It just won't work. Nobody's going to come.
Because it can't work in a place like this.
It can't work, and it's just, you know, forget it.
He renovated an old garage that his grandfather had once owned and was later used for school buses.
Wally Grossman's bus garage.
Wally Grossman.
I remember Wally when I was in school here. He was the head of the bus drivers.
Across from you is someone that hurt you very badly. You've got to forgive them.
Daniels built his own company of actors and technicians from nearby communities and created a year-long apprenticeship program to train young people.
Guess we're tired today.
Guy Sanville, the artistic director here for 20 years, is another Michigan native who left for New York and came back.
New York is a great place, but we wanted to raise our families here. We wanted to be able to put our kids on the bus in the morning when they go to school. And it's just it's a little slower pace, but just as rich, I think.
All fine, but to survive, Purple Rose had to build an audience in a small town with no professional theaters and little cultural life.
You have to create that. You have to get them to not just go to the plays that have a happy ending. You know, is it a comedy? Okay, it's not a comedy. When's the next comedy?
Mm-hmm.
All right, I'll come to that.
Mm-hmm.
And you have to get those people to take a chance once in a while.
And how'd you do that?
With comedy. You got to get them in the building. It's still a sale. Art out here is more often than not a guy who lives north of town.
But then what happens?
Then we go to see Tennessee Williams, and they get their ears pinned back.
That was brilliant. Let's do that again.
It hasn't perfect. Been easy, but 25 years later, Purple Rose is still here, a creative and economic engine in the town.
They used to roll up the sidewalks at 6 o'clock on a Saturday night. Well, now it's booming, and it's not just the theater, but the theater has been a great draw. It's a town of 5,000 people. We draw 40,000 people a year.
It's the role of a lifetime.
The theater commissions new plays from contemporary writers, and Daniels has made himself a playwright. Casting Session is his 16th play written for Purple Rose.
You got a slide thing on it, don't you? Let's keep that.
He's also developed another Michigan-centered piece of his artistic life as a musician and part of a traveling band.
I'm in the mood.
It's a family affair, including his two sons, Ben, a guitarist, and Luke, who serves as manager.
Say, sing misery.
We watch the band rehearse in a newly built studio on what Daniels jokingly calls the family compound. The next day, some 150 miles away in Three Oaks, Michigan, they performed at the Acorn Theater. The first gig in a month-long road trip west and back, mostly playing in smaller cities and towns.
Hat don't help.
Acting in major films, writing plays, founding his own theater company, and on the road playing music. It began with one big decision made early on to move back home. But nothing about this life, says Daniels, was the slightest bit inevitable.
I remember saying goodbye to my dad across the lake. And I remember driving down the road, tears in my eyes, because you're 21, you're from a small town. Nobody is an actor from this town. And I wish I could jump in that car and tell that 21-year-old, look, you're going to have some success. It's going to be great. You're going to learn a lot. It's really not going to happen until your late 50s. So just hang in there. Hang in there.
For about 35, 40
years. Yeah, and just be patient. Be patient.
Hang in there and maybe succeed on your own terms. From Chelsea, Michigan, I'm Jeffrey Brown for the PBS NewsHour.